Hi everyone, and welcome to another daily video from Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. My name is Ricky Hayes, and today's video is how to make a high converting Shopify landing page in 5 minutes. All right, so in previous videos, we've gone through importing a product and then doing product description. Just watch my previous videos for that. Use it as a template. Keep using this all-in-one food chopper and slicer for the reference product. Now, first thing you want to do, install Brooklyn as your theme. I use Brooklyn. It works really well. Ignore how I put show now. It should be shop now. That's just a typo. But basically, the cool thing I like about Brooklyn is it's quick and it's easy. And there's just a few things that we need to do. So we go to product page. We go enable product zoom. We don't want to show the product vendor. We want to change it to thumbnail, because on mobile it's going to be thumbnail anyway. And we show quantity picker. We choose drop down. I find drop down works better rather than having heaps of various ones. I don't use the dynamic checkout button, and you want to make your add to cart button large. All right, so that's pretty much all you need to do there. You can see just how quick and easy it is. And because we've already got the product description, that works perfectly fine. The next step is you want your trust badge, at least under your add to cart button. I have a previous video on making your add to cart button shake as well. Not mandatory, but it definitely helps with click-through rates of your add to cart button. So I suggest going and watching that one. But in relation to your trust badge, just Google trust badges Shopify. You can find these. I will upload it to my group, Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle, on Facebook. I just use this one. Well, it works fine. There's a million different debates about which one's best. But if we go back here now, and we want to go edit code, and you want to go to template liquid. So in Brooklyn, it's product template liquid, and then you want to go add to cart. Yes, add to cart, and that's the exact button that we're after. Then you want to put in open bracket ing src for source equals quotation mark. And did I already? No, I didn't. Okay, sorry. So once you download the file, the add to cart, the trust badge file, you then upload into your files here, and you get this. You'll get this. And as a link, you just copy that link. Once you put in the code IMG SRC equals and quotation marks that, and then close bracket, go save, preview. Should be able to go food cutter, and there it is. So you can see how just quick and easy that is, and see how that fits really nicely in there. That just only took me 20 seconds. So you can see how now we got a really good name, we've got the add to cart button, we got trust badge, we've got our text. All right, so the next step is to make it a high converting product page, we want to edit the actual product itself. Where is the product? Sorry, I'm trying to do this quick so it's more condensed. There's, because there's a couple of other little things I want to add. All right, so first thing, make sure you do have inventory, so at least one. Save. You want to then go into highlight all your variants. If you only have one, obviously it's fine. And you want to change your compare at price to at least double what it is your actual price. So that's $37. So 74. So $73.99. Whoops. $73.99. $73.99. And there we go. So the reason that we do that is, if I now refresh this page, It changes the color, which you can change, by the way, yourself if you wish to change that. But you can see how they're going to see that it's 50% off, because my strategy is you do 50% off for your marketing and people will see that. So it's congruent with that. That's pretty much all there is to it. Now, I do use Ali Reviews because I changed theme on this store. It just hasn't installed the widget. When just install Ali Reviews. I have a video on that as well with how to get high converting reviews in a secret method that no one else uses. So now we've got that. Now the other things that you will want to do is, so again, this is working under the premise that you have all your policies down the bottom. So your refund policy, your returns policy, your privacy policy, tracking, about us, contact us, all of that. I just haven't added that to this development store, but you just add that in. That's a way of trust, and you add it up to the top as well, okay? Because that is all a part of the experience of having a page, but I'm just talking about doing the page itself. All right, so now we have that. One other thing that I do, so again, if the widget was down the bottom there, which is just Ali Reviews, is the app that I use, absolutely fantastic. You can see that the other parts that I wanted to quickly discuss, two parts, was I've run through this in a previous video. These are the base apps that you need. Ali Reviews, Best Currency Converter, Free Shipping Bar, Klaviyo for email marketing, Oberlo for your order fulfillment, Personalized for upsells, cross-sells, in-cart upsells as well, your tracking from AfterShip, and Wheelio for exit intent. Okay, so install all of these apps. That will help give you a base for a high converting landing page. I have previous videos on how these are configured. Very easy to configure as well. So I suggest going through those. But the last thing I wanted to do was, sorry about that. So the next part you wanna do is go to Google and put in Unicode Arrows, okay? The reason that you wanna do this is very simple. Basically, you just want an arrow to guide the person. And I like this arrow. So I copy this arrow. Then I go back to here and I go edit languages. Under edit languages, add to cart. We type in the code of what we see on our product page or the word. So see how add to cart? And basically all you do is you copy that. So now you have an arrow. So firstly, we'll just double check that's applied. Let's check it on mobile. Yep, so we've got an arrow. And the other thing I also do is a plus in front of it. So plus, remember, there's a lot of psychology to marketing, all right? So marketing is really psychology. It really, that's all it boils down to. We refresh the page again. So now we have an ad. Doesn't this look nice? Like, I mean, this is how it always looks on mobile. Another reason I really like Brooklyn, very photogenic. You can get apps to resize the images. It's not the end of the world. So we have really nice images. We have our currency converter. Ignore that. That's just because I haven't replaced the logo. We have our variant chooser. We also now have our current price and our price that it is normally 50% off. You have your quantity selector, you have your add to cart button, you have your actual trust badge, you have nice product description, specification, and then as I said, because I changed theme, I just haven't reinstalled the code, but basically you would have your reviews widget here, and then following that video, you have the reviews there. You have your policies that I've put in a previous video as well. And that's pretty much it. That's pretty much all you need to do to then have a high converting starting landing page. This will work really well. You can see how it has all the points that are needed without being intrusive. That's all you really need to do. So just remember, follow this. There's an app you can use for that. I don't recommend it. It just takes 5 seconds to do what I did there. You can see how nice that looks. Only took me a few minutes. And you can see how, as a whole, this product page is coming together. As I said, I've made a number of videos, the fundamental apps, the back end of Shopify, how to configure the apps, and how to find a product, product research, adding it to your store, bumping up your product page, and now it looks like this. Now, I've gone in depth about this, so now if you watch all my videos, you'll see exactly how you can do this. Now, would you not agree that this is a nice page that's likely to convert them in? Aside from that, it just annoys the shit out of me. But you can see how just with barely any work, I've made a page that looks nice and is likely to convert. So the reason that I suggest learning this skill is that you will be doing this a lot. So definitely try and learn this skill, okay? So that's pretty much it from today's video. There isn't that much more to it. The reason that I wanted to start here is just that this is where you want to start with having a nice looking landing page. Basically, that's all you really need to do to get started. Now, as I said, a part of the reason that if I actually go here, I'm getting a bit anal about this now. Go back to the food cutter. I wonder if it has installed the widgets. Okay. So yeah, you can see it's got the shipping bar. Again, it hasn't installed the other widget, but most of the apps will reinstall themselves as well. So when you set up your store, just make sure you install Brooklyn straight away, then install your apps, then follow this, and you're pretty much all good to go. Again, doesn't need to be perfect. Just follow this. It's a starting point, and you'll improve it over time. All right? You don't need timers. You don't need a huge amount of scarcity. Just this, just to instill trust, okay? All right, so that's pretty much it from today's video. If you did like today's video, drop a like, hit the subscribe button, drop a comment below if you have any questions, and hit the notification bell. I update you all with new videos every day. My Facebook group, Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle, is growing rapidly every day. More and more members. Very versatile, highly intelligent group. Link below if you wish to join the group. I respond to most people, and so we help each other, all right? So I hope you have liked today's video. You all have a lovely day, and take care. Thank you very much for your time. Goodbye.